everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Clairvoyance, and I'm your tarot viz Akriti. So in our today's video we are going to discuss about the different tarot cards, and I'll be introducing a little bit about the tarot course that I teach in my center, and that is what I teach online also. And so we'll be talking about different decks. For example, there's a Rider-Waite deck, then there's Angel deck, there's Oracle cards, then I have another Oracle card which is a Rama Oracle card, and then we have different kinds of, you know, the pictography is absolutely different in each you know card when we talk about. So stay tuned for more, and I'll be showing you each and every deck as well, so stay tuned. So hello everyone, like I said, we will be making a video on different tarot decks. So today I'm introducing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 deck of mine, though there are lots and lots of decks. If I talk about, you know, the variety and the range of decks, so there are a lot of decks, but mostly the ones that I am using are these 5 decks. And starting from the very old and the basic beginners yet advanced deck, that is the Rider-Waite deck. All right, this is the outer of the Rider-Waite deck, that's the back side, and these are the images. So this is the Rider-Waite deck. So this Rider-Waite deck, you know, the main the property for this Rider-Waite deck is that, you know, this is the deck which forms the base of all the tarot cards. So you know, this deck was made by Rider and Waite, and this deck is the oldest deck existing. And these images are, you know, these are the best images one can get. So since these are very old, this is very old deck, so the images and the interpretation is also a little bit, I would say, of that era. Nowadays, improvised version of this Rider-Waite deck has come, you know, in which, so for example, if I say, if I'm talking about somebody who is a Knight of Wand, so probably if I'll see a new version of this Rider-Waite deck, you know, wherein the people have modified this deck, so probably somebody who's riding a motorbike, you know, instead of riding a horse, so here it is a knight, but over there, you know, somebody who's riding a motorbike. So the deck has been modified a lot, and Rider-Waite deck is such that, you know, a lot of modification has been done. Like I said, the you know, the base remains the same for all the decks, irrespective of you know, the kind of images they are representing. So when we talk about tarot deck, you know, the main thing that you know comes in tarot is the pictographic representation of any card. All right, so for example, if I see this card, this is Six of Pentacles or Six of Coin, this is Queen of Pentacles. So the kind of colors, what the image is representing, and you know, what you actually interpret from that image is what actually means in tarot. So when we talk about doing predictions in tarot, a lot of people have asked me this question that, ma'am, do all tarot card readers do 100% accurate prediction? How do you judge that it is going to be 100% accurate prediction? So my answer to this question is that, you know, it depends upon reader to reader. If I make one coherent set and you know, and two tarot card readers, the coherent is going to pick almost 99% the same card. It is just that, you know, the interpretation done by the tarot card reader number one and the tarot card reader number two would be different, because that depends on you know, the tarot card reader, that what sort of how actually that tarot card reader is interpreting the card. It is all about the interpretation of the card. So for example, somebody, if I am interpreting Ace of Cups, so probably I'll say it's a new beginning of something, and as you can see, the water flowing out of this cup. So cups represent emotions. All right, so probably I would say a new love affair in life, or a new, you know, beginning of something new. This is, I think, this is my interpretation. Somebody who's a tarot card reader, probably that person might interpret it in a different way. So it depends upon the interpreter, it depends upon the tarot card reader, what exactly they are interpreting. And in Rider-Waite deck, we do upright reading also and reverse reading also. So for example, if it's Queen of Cups, so this is an upright form. So probably it might, it can come in the reverse form also. So we do a reading in reverse form. Some readers, they do reverse reading also. Some readers, they don't do. So again, it is upon the interpreter, the tarot card reader, what exactly and how they are interpreting the card. So this was about the Rider-Waite deck. Now I'm going to talk about another deck that I've been using, that is Osho Zen. So Osho Zen was basically, this deck was made by one of Rajneesh Osho's student, and this is also one of the wonderful deck, I would say. Images in this card is something like this. It's a success card, number 6 of, it's a red color, number 6 card. So, the background is the backside of the card is this. So it is said that this, basically this black thing is the signature of Rajneesh Osho. All right. So this is the card and it has beautiful images, no doubt. So this is the master card. This is Rajneesh Osho himself. And they're beautiful interpretations. So this card is of maturity. This card is of turning in, then again flowering. So it has colorful images. It has beautiful deck. So this is all about Osho Zen card. And in Osho Zen, as you can see, the background is a little black, but the meaning of this deck is really good. Like for example, if I see 8 of air, so 8 of air over here means guilt. Can you see the image? It is such a nice image. If I have to interpret this card, so this card actually means, though this deck already comes with a booklet wherein all the images have been interpreted by the person himself who has made this deck, and interpretation is also given and the meaning is also given of the deck, but when I interpret this this image of 8 of air of guilt, it says that it is all in your head and nothing else. And this once you clear out your head, once you remove these clouds of confusion, of this guilt, so there's a lot of greenery around you. That is when you can see this greenery. But you have to come out of your thoughts, you have to come out of this guilt, only then you will be able to see this beautiful time that is there in future for you. Then again, it's a moment to moment card, fighting again with your own thoughts. That is what is, and mainly it is talking about that you have become so defensive that you're not ready to listen to people. Then is ordinariness, isolation, postponement. So there are beautiful cards in this Osho Zen deck. Whenever I want to take out a little bit of deeper thoughts, as in what exactly my client is going through, or what exactly is the situation, if I want a deeper reading, so that is when I pick my this Osho Zen deck. So this deck actually gives me the inner thought procedure of my client and the situation around my client. And when I am mostly, I want to know just the right, the yes and no decision for me, or a clear cut answer, so I go with Rider-Waite mostly. Okay, apart from that, I've been using these oracle guidance cards also. So again, it's a very beautiful card. As you can see, the backside is of the angel feathers, and it has beautiful interpretation, of course, no doubt. It says study, friendship, freedom. So all these images, romance, miracle, divine guidance. So, you know, these images are basically giving you the messages. So this oracle guidance card is basically for messages. So if I want to know, you know, if I want a message for myself or for my client or for my situation, that, you know, what should we do? What should be the guidance? So probably it says miracle. So something miraculous is going to happen. You have to believe in miracles. Or romance, you need to increase romance. Or freedom from your own thoughts. Or, you know, so these are basically guidance cards. So these are really nice guidance cards. Though these are very limited cards. It is not completely, you know, like 78 deck. Mostly we have 78 cards in a deck. And depending upon vice versa upon the deck, that is, but these cards are a little less. These are not exactly your 78 cards. Okay, so this was about little bit about guidance oracle card. Then we have angel deck. Okay, another famous deck is the angel deck, and of course, yes, it has again beautiful images to interpret. Again, I would say the base is the Rider-Waite deck, but it is more of improvised version of Rider-Waite deck. As you can see, Nine of Earth. So in this deck, the speciality of this deck is, if you know, the image is there, Nine of Earth is specially written, and then the message is also written. So sometimes, you know, as a tarot card reader also, we find block, we you know, we get stuck up in certain situations. So this is a very helpful thing, you know, when we talk about this. So for example, over here it's written, for Nine of Earth, enjoying life's little luxuries, spending quiet time alone, successful self-employment. So you know, whichever line relates to you is the one for you. So if I overall interpret this card, it says that, you know, you need to spend a little bit of time alone with yourself and involve yourself more in the self-employment, and you need to enjoy life's little luxuries. Okay, and you can only do this when you spend a little bit of time with yourself first. So Nine of Earth talks about, you know, spending a little time alone. So this was one image. Then we have over here King of Earth. So King of Earth, they have written down the main characteristics of what King of Earth is. So for example, over here it's written that King of Earth is somebody who's very generous, who's very professional, who's responsible, who's practical. And at the same time, the short message for King of Earth is, a successful time, confidently accept opportunities you are offered, the Midas touch. So that means, you know, he's somebody who's very successful, who's successful professionally, who's very confident, and he needs to, you know, accept opportunities that are being offered to this person. Okay, and he's somebody who's very practical, who has a practical approach, who's very professional, who's very generous, and at the same time is very responsible also. So these are the characteristics of King of Earth. So and apart from that, when we actually, you know, use this deck, so there are small angel prayers that you can say, so that, you know, the archangels can come and help you with the, you know, protection of this deck. And apart from that, protection of this deck, you know, protecting yourself, protecting your surroundings. And predictions, like I said, it is not upon the deck what I mean the accuracy of the prediction. It is upon the interpreter, whosoever is interpreting these decks, that how accurate, you know, the prediction is going to be. All right, so this was with the angel deck, and it's a wonderful deck. It has a lot and lot of information, and mostly when I want to have a deep insight about my you know, about the situation, about the client's reading and all, so I go for angel deck whenever I need help. And I, you know, and I'm looking for solutions, so I go for angel deck. So this is again, like I said, a wonderful deck to go for. Now, next I'm going to talk about is the Oracle of Rama. Basically, this deck is one of India's ancient oracle. In India, you know, there is something called as Ramayana. So this deck is basically based on Ramayana itself. So Ramayana is like one of the holy books for you know, Hindus, and in this deck, as you can see the images, so this deck is divided into two, okay, and these are 56 cards basically, and it has a booklet of course. So we have seven of these cards. So these seven cards are basically the interpretation of you know, of the main characters in Ramayana. So we have number one is the Hanuman. He is the power of active devotion. He's somebody, you know, who has been, he's a monkey warrior, and he was Rama's devoted servant. And we you know, in this Rama oracle, it has been represented, Hanuman has been represented as the power of active devotion, that nobody can be so devoted like Hanuman. So Hanuman was the one who was very devoted towards you know, Rama. And apart from that, then we have Lakshmana. He was a brother of Rama and main companion. Then we have Bharat. He was another brother of Rama, and he represents the power of responsibility, because once Ram went to the forest, you know, Vanvas and all. So after that, Bharat was the one who, you know, who actually handled the whole empire. Then we have Sita, the goddess, the main, you know, the person, goddess, she was incarnation of the goddess. Then we have Rama himself, again, he's the god, and god incarnated on a divine life quest, okay. Then there's Shatrughan. Shatrughan was another brother, and he is called the power, he has the power of destroying obstacles, Shatrughan. So he was the defender, okay. Then we have the holy name, the power and pure devotion towards Ram's name, and that is the sign Om itself, okay. So Om sign, all right. So it has a lot and lot of power, this deck. I must tell you, whenever I do this deck, this is a very powerful deck. It will tell you the solution also, it will tell you the problem also, it is going to tell you, it's a complete deck. All right, so I'll show you the image of the main deck. Apart from these seven cards, the main deck is this. So over here it's written which verse, because this book, this card, this oracle of Rama is based on Ramayana. So it talks about the verses. For example, deep into the forest, exile is the main the situation, this is the situation going on. Then the section, what section it was. So Rama is banished, the mother of Ram's brother Bharat deceives the king. Then what is the indication? This was the section, all right, of the main Ramayana. But what is the indication? So indication, in general not favorable, as one goes through a time that appears to be unfair. That means something unfair is going to happen around you, and the time is not favorable for you. Then we have, you know, the further seven solutions. And when I pick one of the cards, so after I pick one of the cards, so I have to only read that one, that is the main one. So for example, when I pick, so it says a number one card, all right. So I have to read the first one, the first one is relevant for me. So it says indications of a great destiny. Right now the time is not favorable, and you know, everything appears to be unfair, but it is the indication of a great destiny. Something great is going to happen in future. Just like, you know, Ram had just like Ram was banished and you know Bharat's mother deceived the king, so similarly, and it was destiny, this all was destiny towards something great. So similarly, you know, something great is going to come up. So this was the main the reading. So this was for Rama's oracle. So today I'm only going to discuss about these five cards and how these five cards are very, these five decks that I've been using in my reading mostly. So if you want to know more, if you want to learn these decks, any of these decks, the Rama Oracle, the Rider Waite, Osho Zen, Angel cards, the Oracle of, the Guidance Oracle cards. If you want to learn any of these decks, you can leave a comment on the comment section below. You can even, DM me on my Instagram page, which is Tarot Wiz, or you can even, leave a mail for me. You can go through my website, you can check out all the details, you can leave a mail if you want to leave, if you want to learn these tarot decks. All right, so I've been taking a lot of online classes these days, so if you want to join my online class, DM me on Instagram. All right, so this is it for today, and I hope you have understood a little bit about tarot card. This is just the introduction of tarot. Tarot is a huge science and a wonderful science. It is an occult science, which is science beyond science. And I hope you like today's session. So if you want me to make any more videos with regard to any other course, please comment on the comment section below, or leave you can DM me on my Instagram page Tarot Wiz for any other course that you want me to introduce to you. All right, so this is it for today. Thank you so much. Have a good day.